Yeah, this is where we're gonna be walking today with Brother Pete. I'll be going with him too. Although I've had an amazing miracle, but for all my life I couldn't walk in the sun. My skin would scratch and my body will start having these red marks coming up. And yesterday, for the first time, I went out in the sun, and for the first time ever, my skin didn't itch. And I want to give God glory and thanks for sending his apostle to Trinidad, Pete Cabrera, to be a great blessing to us. We have seen miracles, like this woman had an accident and a piece of metal went into her ears. And the first night he came down, the woman's ears was completely restored and healed. And now she's hearing in the ear, perfect sound. And that's not the only miracle, but many other miracles took place. Like, there was this guy who is 92 years of age, and he also got healed as well too. He couldn't walk, he was bent backward, a gate fell on him, and he, by the time Pete finished prayed for him, his back came back into alignment and he was able to walk strong. There was also this widow that came last night, and she had pain in her knees and swelling in her feet. And she was completely healed and whole as well too. So, you know, all those who are blessing to Brother Pete, I want to thank you all for releasing him to come here to Trinidad and Tobago. And I believe that he is going to come again at the next appointed time to be a great blessing in our nation. And I just really want to say thanks to everybody in the U.S. for all your prayers, all your love, all your support. We are just really blessed to be doing this, what God have called us to get done. And I love Brother Pete, and my prayers will be with him as long as God gives me the health and the strength to be praying for him. We'll be praying for him and releasing a prayer covering over him, his beautiful wife and his children. And it's just really an honor to have him here. So, the teachings were dynamic. We learned so much that now that we have the manuals and stuff like that, we will actually be carrying teams on the streets. When you leave Trinidad, we will actually be going forth, praying and taking your advice to set up a place where we could go forth into the streets and really minister healing and the love of God and the compassion of God and, you know, the heart of God. So the teachings are excellent. Thank you very much.
So, to all the people that are watching, like, what's the difference between the way I teach and the way that other ministers teach?
Well, you teach, there's just a real simplicity. The littlest of child could understand what you're saying. The littlest of child can understand what you're teaching. And it's so simple. It's really, really easy in terms of what you're sharing with the believers. I mean, we have never heard it downloaded in such a simple way ever in our lives.
Where are you going?
So anyways, the reason that I put Rohan on is because sometimes I like people to hear like what God is doing through what we're doing. And for all you that have been watching me on Facebook, on YouTube, I like to go out and the thing that I like to do the most is to equip people. Like, that's what I do the most. And so I'm not into preaching, I'm not into giving sermons, I'm into actually demonstrating who we could be in Christ and basically teaching people that, look, if I can walk in this, you can walk in this. And so that's what this whole ministry is about. It's not really a ministry, it's just being a disciple of Christ. And so, guys, we've been in Trinidad now. I'll be leaving tomorrow. I mean, I've been here 3 days and it's been nonstop. I'm serious, like, we're always late. Seems like we're always running late because we're doing so much. But we're on our way right now this morning, and
everyone is speeding.
Yeah, and like, so I mean, guys, if you hear about Rohan, the Prayer Command Center, how can they get a hold of you?
Like, on the website, www.rohan,
R-O-H-A-N.
Rambly,
and I'm gonna have it right here. You'll see it right here, like right here.
Dot
org. And so, guys, if you want to see what he's doing, guys, I went to an orphanage yesterday. I mean, it just broke my heart. I'm just start crying from like what I was seeing. But the amazing thing is that they're not forgotten, and there's men of God that are fighting for the lost. They're actually out there in the trenches. Guys, this isn't a pretty place. It's an island, and it's got its pretty places, but I didn't come to be on vacation. I didn't come to, so I haven't even seen the ocean, you know? So we've been in the slums, we've been in the hood, we've been in the places of the lost, the forgotten, the unloved, and that's where we've been going, and we've just been loving on people, praying for people. And the team that we've been ministering to is excited, they're on fire, they want to be used more of God, they want to be used in the kingdom of God. And so, Rohan's mother, this is her right here, amazing blessing. Yeah. Hey, I want to tell you guys something.
She's the cook.
Yeah, I do cook.
Godly parents. If you're a godly parent, you will raise up powerful men of God and women of God. So get to know your word, get to know your Lord. Hold on to them, don't let go. Raise your kids in the way of the Lord. They'll never stray, they'll never go away from them. And so, his mother is the reason that he is the way he is.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And so, guys, we need godly families. We need godly women and godly men to be an example to the rest of the church body. And, guys, the reason I go to churches is because they really love the Lord. The people in church, they just don't understand the kingdom of God, the kingdom principles, and the kingdom laws. And so that's the reason that God has chose us to do this. And so I got Rohan on here, and we'll go from there.